Hello, this is Ilyan, and in this video, we're going to take a look at how to install your very own MeshCentral server. And this will allow you to set up your own cloud server for remotely managing all your computers, and this for free. So let's take a look at it right now. So getting set up with your own MeshCentral server is super easy. MeshCentral is entirely built in Node.js. So the first thing we're gonna do is install Node.js on a computer. Now, if you're on Windows, what you do is you will open a browser. Let's take a look at this here. I'm gonna open a new browser and I am going to go to the nodejs.org website. And so normally what you would do is you would go to your favorite search engine, type Node.js, and hit the first link here and you would see it. Right now there's version 14 is the current version of Node, and the latest version is 15. So you install this on your computer. If you're on Linux, often it's already installed. If not, you go ahead and install it. You follow the instructions that you have for your operating system. So then I'm going to open a box here, a shell box, and you can type node minus V and you will see the version of Node that you're running. Now I'm currently running the minimum version that MeshCentral will run on, which is 6.0.0. But typically you would run version 10 or version 15 or something like that. So to get started, you'll create a new directory. So for example, you'll make a new directory called MC or MeshCentral. And I already did this, so I'm going to change into this directory. And then what you would do is you would type npm install MeshCentral. And that will install the latest version of MeshCentral from the npm packages website over to your computer. If you want to install a specific version of MeshCentral, you can say at, and then for example, 0.7.49, for example, if you wanted that version of MeshCentral. But if you don't specify a version, then it will install the latest one available. So normally you would hit enter here, it will take a few minutes and get MeshCentral installed on your computer. And then you would type node, mesh, and then node, let's see, node modules slash MeshCentral. And actually I'm on Windows, so the slash is this way. And then you hit enter. Now, normally MeshCentral at this point would install a couple of additional modules that it needs, depending on what OS you're running on and what configuration you have. Once those modules are installed, it will create a set of certificates that are unique to your server, that will authenticate your server, and then you're ready to go. Now, I'm already running my own server on this machine, but for demonstration purposes here, you'll notice that this MeshCentral server is on port 82 and on port 446. And it is in LAN mode, so we'll cover that later. But I'll go back into my browser here. And well, another thing to note is that the server has no users. The next new account will be site administrator. So once you get your MeshCentral server installed, don't delay. Right away, localhost. In this case here, it is port 82, enter. It will redirect me to port 446, which is the HTTPS port that my server is on. And here, the server is running by default a self-signed certificate for the TLS. You say advanced and we'll accept it here. But in the future, you can replace that certificate with a Let's Encrypt certificate or your own certificate, and that will work just fine. So now there's no account on this server right now, so I'm going to create a new one, and I'm going to type admin, admin.com, for example. It doesn't matter. And I'll say create account. And there we go. We have our own server, and I kind of locked in the administrator for this website. So if I log out now, you'll notice that there's no option to create a new account. And that's because by default, you're not allowed to create new accounts on the login screen. The only exception is when you're when there's no users. In that case, the account can be created. So I'm going to log back in, admin, and I have my own MeshCentral server here, and I can start proceeding to creating new groups, installing stuff, creating installing computers and so on, and so forth. So that is it right here. Now, if you ever want to update your MeshCentral server, you click on here and it says check server version. You select that and it will tell you what version you have, what is the current stable and latest version. And if you want, you can just select the version you want, click OK. And about 10 to 20 seconds later, the server will restart and get the have the latest updated version. So that's very practical. Now, another thing you may want to know is, well, okay, I'm running the server from the command prompt here. So if I do Control C on the command prompt, you'll see that the web page now clears out. And it says server disconnected. By the way, if I run the server again, this web page, while it says disconnected, is trying again periodically to reconnect to the server. And so after a while, it should reconnect, or I can, there it goes. It reconnected and you see the login page here. So that's nice. But let's suppose I want to run the server in the background. What do I do? Well, I can do Control C, and then when you do --- help, so you run node modules, MeshCentral --- help, you'll see a couple of extra commands here that are useful. The first set of commands allow you to run MeshCentral in the background. So you can do --- install, uninstall, start, stop, restart. And this will control the background service of Windows, or if you're on Linux, it will install yourself as a Linux systemd process. Now, just make sure that you're running as root or as an elevated user when you do that, so that you have permission to go and change those settings. There's a bunch of other settings that are useful. One I use a lot is --- user. Obviously, I'm a developer, so I don't want to log in to the website over and over again. So I tap --- user admin. And this allows me, when I hit refresh here, to log in straight into admin all the time. So basically, you're bypassing the login screen. So if you're in a private network, you're only using MeshCentral on your own, you don't want authentication, then that's the solution for you. The other set of commands that are quite important are the bottom one. Those are recovery commands. So if you ever lose the administrator account for your server, you can create a new account and you can reset an account if you want to take an existing account and set a new password and disable two-factor authentication. And you can also promote an existing account to server administrator. So these should be done as a last resort. They're not intended to be done while your server's running. But you know, if you lose your admin account and so on and you're stuck, then you shut down your server and you run this command to recover your administrator account. Okay. So this is basically how you set up MeshCentral. It should take you like just a few minutes to do. If you're on Windows, there's also a Windows installer right here. And actually I already have it installed here, but you can run this installer. It will install the Node.js for you, download it, install it, and then it will do NPM and all the stuff. For you. But if you're an expert, I suggest you ditch the tool and go with the command line. You'll have a lot more flexibility going in the future. So anyway, this is quickly how to install MeshCentral.com. Hope you learned something and have a great day. Thank you.